We're going to say formal charge. Now, this is going to be different than what you're going to see in lecture. This is a much simplified way of looking at it. We're going to say that formal charge equals group number minus the bonds that element is making plus its non-bonding electrons, each individual electron. This is the simplest way to look at it. In lecture, you may see instead, formal charge equals valence number, and remember, group number equals valence number, minus half of your bonding electrons plus your non-bonding electrons. I personally don't like to introduce halves into calculations, so instead of saying half of your bonding electrons, I just say number of bonds. It's the same exact thing. If you use this simpler, more simpler version, you'll get the same answer. Now, we said we use the formal charge formula to check if we drew the compound correctly. When you do formal charge, you're only able to get three possible answers. The answers that you can get are minus one, zero, or plus one. So if you get a formal charge that's not one of those three numbers, that's a strong indication that you drew the compound incorrectly. Next, and most importantly, if you add up all of the formal charges of each individual element, they have to add up to the overall charge of the compound. So let's say we had to draw SO4 2-. When we draw it and we take the formal charge of all of the oxygens plus the sulfur, their total is supposed to give us back the charge of the compound, minus 2. Let's say you have to draw CO2, carbon dioxide. When you take the formal charges of the two oxygens and the carbon, it should add up to 0. If it doesn't, you drew it incorrectly. That's the beauty of formal charge. We can look to see if we get one of three answers, negative 1, 0, or plus 1. We can also check to see, do all my formal charges add up to give me the charge of the compound? If they don't, you did something wrong.